Hi there, my name is Kavita Sharma. In case you are new to PMP, this video gives you all the answers. So keep watching. So the first question which people have is, should I do it? It's a difficult course, understand. It would take a whole lot of time, whole lot of effort to do the course. Lot of investment, time and money is required. You need to invest in understand concept, invest in evaluation, do a lot of quizzes, and then you can pass the PMP exam. If you pass the PMP exam, the positive it comes with is you can write PMP in your signature. This PMP signature brings a lot of value to you. It shows that you know project management. You get better interview calls. Lot of current employers have this filter criteria wherein they write only PMP people should apply. So you get better job opportunities. You get better salary, 25% more than other counterparts who are non-PMPs. You have done PMP, that means you know lot of things and you become efficient as a manager. So if you think you cannot have this much of time or you don't want to go with PMP, you can stop watching the video now. So the next question is, am I eligible for PMP? So three things are required for you to be eligible. In case you are starting afresh, you are new to your career, you are fresh out of college, the certification which you need to look for is CAPM. This certification, PMP certification, is for experienced project managers. Now what is it? How much experience? So you need to have a bachelor degree. What is the meaning of bachelor degree? You need to have 16 years of project management experience. What it means is we have 12 years of education plus a degree, a bachelor degree of 4 years. If you do not have a 4-year degree, you can have 12 plus 3 plus any other degree, 2 or 1 or whichever. So you become qualified. In case you meet this criteria of 16 years, then you need to have 36 months of project management experience. Lot of people have doubt on this line. Now what is it? 36 months of project experience, if you are an IC, individual contributor, like SAP consultant or DBA or a faculty, then people think they are not, they do not have relevant experience. That is not correct. What is a project? A project is something. A project is an initiative which has a start date, end date, and produces some unique result. Now, people would, SAP or DBA would have rolled out new changes or new product. People who are in operations would have rolled out upgrades. All of those are, or changes, all of these are considered projects. So if those project experience constitute 36 months, then you are qualified. The last thing is 35 PDUs. In case you are a CAPM certified, you don't need this last thing. But in case you are not, you have not done CAPM, then you need to read 35 PDU. Or CAPM certification. If in case you are not CAPM certified, don't worry, then you need 35 PDUs. What is 35 PDU? An ATP, an authorized training provider, should teach you for 35 hours on the prescribed project management content. So this would come from me or any other person whom you go and get trained from. Next question is, how much money? So the money can be divided into three things. The first one is membership cost. It is straightforward. If you want to become a member with PMI, it's an yearly membership. So you need to spend, if you are new, you need to spend $139. If you are renewing your membership, then you need to spend only $129. The second cost is training cost to get those 35 PDUs. Now this training cost varies. If you are in India, this would be cheaper. If you are in US, this would be costly. So you need to find out what works for you. So this can be in a range from $150 to $2,500. Find out which training works for you, enroll for that. This will give you 35 PDUs. The exam cost is the third component, which is 405 for the members. If you don't want to become a member, then the examination cost is $555. Now, the exam cost can vary based on the country you are in. So if you are in India, a member need to spend very less on the examination fee. So check at the local site as how much examination cost PMI is offering for your region. So now you are qualified, you are eligible, and you know how much total money you need to spend. The total money would be $139 plus $405, which is, it goes to PMI, plus training cost or 35 PDU cost, which goes to the ATP. This would be total cost which you need to spend. How much time and efforts are required? So I'm going to talk about Pass PMP in 21 days plan. To understand the concept, you would need 35 hours. So this would be 2 hours per day for 10 days or 15 days. This is the workshop timings. So you need to attend a workshop. So this workshop time would be whatever workshop you're going to attend. After this, the 21 days plan start, which is for 2 hours or 3 hours every day for 12 days. This can extend to 15 or 16 days. So do that, evaluate, read and evaluate your knowledge on each chapter of the PMBOK or each chapter from the PMI material. And then we need to simulate the entire PMP exam. Simulation is 4 hours or now 230 minutes for just see where exactly you buying the mock test from. So do at least 3 mock tests. You can go for 10 mock tests. So for 10 days, you need to do this. 4 hours for at least 3 days. You can go for 10 mock tests. So 10 days. So that is it. If you follow the plan, 21 days plan. So after the workshop, follow 21 days plan and you should be able to pass the PMP exam. So let me summarize. First of all, investigate. Do you really want to be PMP? What is the job prospect in your industry? What does your boss say? What does your wife say? What does your colleague say? So investigate. Once you think you need to do PMP, check your eligibility. Enroll for any training. So it can be any training within ATP. Once you do that, you get 35 PDUs, you are eligible, so file the PMP application. Once you have filed the PMP application, you need to start prepping for the PMP exam. So 21 days test prep kit. You can buy that and you can be ready for the PMP exam in 21 days. Once you think you are ready for the exam, then only schedule the exam day. You need to pass the exam. Don't take a chance. Think, ensure that you get at least 80% and above in your all mock test. If you start getting 80% and above, then only schedule the exam. Go to the VIEW Prometric Center or schedule your exam at home. Take the exam and pass the exam. That's how the overall PMP journey gonna be. Next steps. So check if you are eligible, do research, do some thinking. And if you think you have time right now, or whenever you have time, enroll for a workshop. That's the next step you're gonna have. Thank you for listening in. My name is Kavita Sharma. Have a very nice day. Bye bye.